Hey guys, hope you remember me. Yeah, I know it's been like over 8 months or something since I've last uploaded, and it's because I was drawing a lot in the meantime, and also I was dealing with a lot of insecurities related to uploading on YouTube. So anyways, what I want to talk about today is burnout. And I think before we get started, this is a series I'm starting called Storytime, where you will see me draw something and talk about various topics. So let's start. Burnout. I'm sure we have all gone through some form of burnout in our careers. What I will talk about today is not short tips and tricks on how to overcome burnout. Instead, what I want to touch upon is the root cause of burnout. I've been dealing with and recovering from a burnout for the past few weeks, and I've identified a few main causes. The first cause, I think, it's to do the same thing over and over again without any change. Like, this is the path to burnout. If you're doing the same thing over and over again without any change, like for example, if you're drawing digitally in the same art style all the time with no tools, with no change in subject matter, with no change in color palettes, with no change in values and all, if you're not experimenting, then for sure you're going to get bored, and if you continue it, then you will burn out. So as you can see on the screen, I'm doing screen tones for a page of my short comic called Yesteryear, which I'm going to submit soon for Silent Manga Auditions manga competition. And this is directly related to me facing burnout. From December until a few days ago, that is 12 January to be exact, I've been drawing this comic non-stop, constantly, non-stop. And the way I calculated things, it takes me like around 8 hours to do a page. And the problem was that the only project that I was working on for the past 1.5 months was this. And also before this, I was working on another comic book, which I decided to quit halfway, as I felt like the story wasn't that good. So for the past few months, to be exact, the only project that I have been working on were comic books. No illustrations, no fan art. I even stopped sketching in my sketchbook. Art like felt more like work rather than having fun, and that is not good. That definitely is not good. I was losing the fun part, but I had a deadline and it was 16th January, so I kept going and finished the work, and after that I was feeling extremely burned out. Also, I want to touch upon the second reason. It is not knowing your limits. We as humans have certain limits, and nowadays I am completely against the 16-hour work days and the toxic hustle culture in general. I think the toxic hustle culture only appeals to the field of manual labor and agriculture. As an artist, you are working with both your mind and your body, and both of them have their own limits. Both your mind and your body have their own limits. Again, check out a video by Brandon Dayton on work ethic, and a video by Adam Duff, Lucid Pixel on burnout. I think they have done very well in explaining this toxic hustle culture and how it causes artists to burn out. So as I was saying, as an artist, you are working with both your mind and your body, and you have certain limits. And also, as Dr. Cal Newport said in his book Deep Work, a person can do deep work only after like 4 hours a day. If you are like drawing focusedly 8 hours a day, you are just, after the 4 hours is done, you are just like, sometimes you are drawing, sometimes you are scrolling through social media, sometimes you are getting distracted by other forms of distractions, such as watching TV, seeing the news, or whatever. So as human beings, we have certain physical and mental limits, and we should know them and respect them. I think 4 to 5 hours of focused drawing and painting a day is way better than 9 hours of time half-assed drawing or painting. And as artists, we need to let our mind wander, to discover new things, to get new ideas, to get inspiration. And you can get inspiration from everything in life. You can get inspiration by going on a walk. You can get inspiration by talking to a person. So as artists, we need to let our mind wander, to discover new things, to get new ideas, and to suck inspiration. Yeah, that's a very strong word. Suck inspiration. My apologies, guys. So the second thing I did wrong was I did not respect my limits and was working way more than I should have, to the point where it felt more like work rather than having fun. I also discovered that when it comes to drawing comics, I have found out that I'm comfortable drawing 2-3 pages a week consistently. Even I think 2-3 pages a week, if done consistently, adds up to a lot. Like if you do 2 pages a week, you are finishing 8 pages a month. And if you're working on it part-time, then I think that's the most amount of time you can spare. Again, it depends from person to person. If you're doing 3 pages a week, you're like finishing 12 pages a month. A lot of artwork. But the thing I did was I was slacking off and was doing 1 page a week in the beginning, and then I was nearing the deadline, and then came January and I had to draw a page every single day to complete it. So I was not following consistency and I had to work a lot at the end to be able to meet the deadline. So I think these are few things that I've discovered that I've done wrong, and if you do these things in this way, I think you will also burn out. So now I would also like to discuss about how I am overcoming burnout. Again, this is the first time I've faced some serious burnout in my life. The last time it did was back in 2020 August, but I took a short 2-3 day break and I recovered after that. And I don't think that was kind of a burnout. It was because of other life issues were interfering with my art, and so I wasn't able to concentrate fully on my art. So I decided to take a 2-3 day break back then. But now I think I'm facing real burnout. So firstly, I would like to check out these two amazing resources related to this. One is a podcast episode of 3-Point Perspective on burnout. I think those guys did a great job on discussing burnout, on why people burn out, on how to overcome it. I think you should definitely check out that podcast episode. And another one is an art talk by Adam Duff, Lucid Pixel. It is called something like Without Sacrificing Artistic Growth, and he touched amazingly at that topic. Now the only way I found to recover from burnout as an artist is to extract yourself from drawing for a little while. Yeah, I know this is scary. This can be scary, and we as artists fear that we might lose our urge to create or our skills if we do not draw for a little while. But this simply is not the case. Art never really leaves the artist. I think, if you truly love art, you'll always be an artist and you will always have the drive to create. And taking a real break, at least 1 or 2 weeks, is necessary to recover from a burnout and to rediscover your love for the craft. And I also think there is a right way to take a break. Again, check out Adam's video that I mentioned earlier. He discusses it very well on how to take a break the right way as an artist without sacrificing growth to get the full info. But let me summarize it a bit, and also let me give my personal take on this. So the thing you need to do is find some other activity, some other creative activity to engage in, and also don't really force yourself to do it. Just do it when you want to do it. I think not doing anything productive, anything fulfilling, anything fun for a long time, any activity that is fulfilling for a long time can be equally stressful as overworking. If you plan to binge TV shows for an entire week, you won't last more than 3-4 days, guys. And I'm talking for experience. I know it sounds ironic to say, you will burn out from watching TV shows and you will want to get back to art. But the thing to do in this break is to not start drawing again. So the thing you need to do is find some other creative activity. It can be like making videos, it can be like writing stories, it can be singing, playing the guitar, whatever. Find some other creative activity to engage yourself in. As for me, I'm writing and making YouTube videos during this break time. I wrote the script for this video, and I'm right now recording the voiceover for this video during my break time. I'm also focusing a lot more on writing stories. I'm writing 1-2 hours every single day, and I think it has helped me a lot to overcome my burnout. But also the difference is that I'm doing these things only when I want to. I'm not forcing myself to be productive. But I also think it's really important to take inspiration during a break. Inspiration can mean many forms. And as Jake Parker describes it, it can be indirect or direct experiences. Indirect experiences are like watching a good film, reading a great book. Experiences include or listening to great music. I personally watched like 2 to 3 films during this break time. I've been reading a lot of books recently, and you can also listen to great music. You can watch TV shows, but don't get too much into it, as I think watching TV shows can be a bit too addictive. And also there are direct experiences include like going out for a walk, to talking to your friends, spending time with your family, talking and meeting new people in your life. All these things in our life help us and force us to be creative. So I don't think anything is unproductive. And also another form of direct experiences is to give your mind some time to think, at least an hour a day. I think you should sit still. I think you should sit still or go for a walk and just think. Don't touch your phone, don't touch any electronics, don't touch a book, don't do anything. Just engage your body in some level of physical activity and think. Thinking is very important. We cannot consume content 24/7. We cannot stimulate ourselves 24/7. So that's that. All these things add up to our art way more than we realize. I hope I'll be able to get back to drawing with a fresh mind, and I'll be starting off with doing master's studies of artworks from my favorite artists like Takehiko Inoue, creator of Vagabond, and Frank Frazetta, etc. And also I will be taking a few precautions to ensure that I will not burn out again. I'll set a fixed and reasonable schedule of 4 hours every day for me to draw, and I'll also do a lot more drawing for fun. I will also do a lot more experimentations with new mediums and techniques, such as like ink washes, digital painting. We'll try out new brushes. We'll also like try to change the subject matter a bit, do some more fan art maybe, or do more original art. I think I will also be making sure that I will respect my physical and mental limits from now on. So if I don't feel like working, I will not work. And with that said, I hope you had a fun time with me chattering in the background while you were drawing or sitting on your ass. A quick disclaimer that it does not matter whatever you were doing, and I hope to see you again in my next video. And this time I promise you won't have to wait like 8 months for my next video. I will uploading once every week from now on.